he comes to you to see what cool stuff you're doing in your lab. That was just a great moment. All right, winning stuffed animals. This may seem mundane to you, but when you're a little kid and you see the big buff guys walking around an amusement park and they got all these big stuffed animals, right? And this is my lovely wife, and I have a lot of pictures of stuffed animals I've won. That's my dad posing with one that I won. I've won a lot of these animals. There's my dad. He did win that one, to his credit. Right? And this was just a big part of my life and my family's life. But, you know, I can hear the cynics. You know, in this age of digitally manipulated things, maybe those bears really aren't in the picture with me, or maybe I paid somebody $5 to take a picture in the theme park next to the bear. And I said, how in this age of cynicism can I convince people? And I said, I know, I can show them the bears. Bring them out. We can just put them right there. We just put them back against the wall. Desmond.
Okay.
Thanks, honey. here are some bears. We didn't have quite enough room in the moving truck down to Chesapeake, and anybody who'd like a little piece of me at the end of this, feel free to come up. First come, first serve. All right, my next one: being an Imagineer. This was the hard one. Believe me, getting to zero gravity is easier than becoming an Imagineer. When I was a kid, I was 8 years old, and our family took a trip cross-country to see Disneyland. And if you've ever seen the movie National Lampoon's Vacation, it was a lot like that. It was a quest. And these are real vintage photographs. And there I am in front of the castle. And there I am, and for those of you who are into foreshadowing, this is the Alice ride. And I just thought this was just the coolest environment I'd ever been in, and instead of saying, gee, I want to experience this, I said, I want to make stuff like this. And so I bided my time, and then I graduated with my PhD from Carnegie Mellon, thinking that meant me infinitely qualified to do anything, and I dashed off my letters of application to Walt Disney Imagineering, and they sent me some of the damn nicest go-to-hell letters I've ever gotten. We have carefully reviewed your application, and presently we do not have any positions available which require your particular qualifications. Now think about the fact that you're getting this from a place that's famous for guys who sweep the street, right? So that was a bit of a setback. But remember, the brick walls are there for a reason, right? The brick walls are not there to keep us out. The brick walls are there to give us a chance to show how badly we want something. Because the brick walls are there to stop the people who don't want it badly enough. They're there to stop the other people. All right, fast forward to 1991. We did a system back at the University of Virginia called Virtual Reality on $5 a day. Just one of those unbelievable, spectacular things. I was so scared back in those days as a junior academic. Jim Foley's here, and I just love to tell this story. He knew my undergraduate advisor, Andy Van Dam, and I'm at my first conference, and I'm just scared to death. And this icon in the user interface community walks up to me and just out of nowhere just gives me this huge bear hug, and he says, that was from Andy. And that was when I thought, okay, maybe I can make it, right? You know, maybe I do belong. And a similar story is that this was just this unbelievable hit, because at the